The internet is full of bro science, fake knowledge, half information or propaganda. Your quest of reliable, authentic health information ends here. So subscribe this channel and hit the bell icon and you never have to go anywhere else ever again.
Hello everyone, how are you today? I'm Dr. Paramjeet and you're watching Dr. Education. Today we are going to talk about how should you clean your ears. I have been asked about this a lot of times and that's why this video is important. And it's a short video. Let me put this straightforward. What is this wax and why do you have to clean your ears? See, your ear canal has hair follicles which actually produces something like wax, a waxy oily substance which is called cerumen. And this oily substance is actually supposed to come out of the ear by itself because its direction is from in and out, inwards out, right? So it should come out. But in some people, genetically, they have very high quantity of wax production or their wax is too hard. And that's why sometimes the wax gets impacted in the canal, which can lead to blockage of the canal and can lead to a lot of problems. Most commonly, it can lead to hearing loss, and believe it or not, this actually is the most common reason for hearing loss in any place, right? So hearing loss, the most common reason is impacted wax, and impacted wax can also lead to ear aches. It can lead to fullness in the ear, noises in the ear like tinnitus, ringing ears, and even partial hearing loss, which I've already told. So why do you have this wax? Why God has made this wax? See, wax is basically, it has a purpose because it actually traps any kind of dust particles, bacteria, germs and other small objects which are entering the ears and prevents the damage to the ear as well as the eardrums, right? And it can actually protect the delicate skin of the ear, inner canal also, because whenever you bathe or you do something, the irrigation can actually damage. That's why it's there to protect you. So it has a role. So how can you clean the wax and regularly, and what to do when you have an impacted wax in the ear? If you have an impacted wax, you can try and dissolve or loosen the wax inside the ear by doing some things. You can put some baby oil or glycerin or mineral oil inside the ear. You can put water inside the ear, or even a commercial drops are available to dissolve the wax. But make sure if you're putting water, it should be of body temperature, because if you put any water which is cooler or warmer than your temperature, it can lead to stimulation of inner ear labyrinth, and that will lead to dizziness and vertigo. Yes, it can lead to dizziness and vertigo. You can even fall. So make sure to do that. And you have to straighten the ear canal. Now, ear canal is something like this. You have to straighten it by keeping your head straight and pulling the tip of the ear lobe. You can pull it backwards, upward and backwards, and your ear canal will get straightened. You can even put water inside and then drain it out by doing something this way, so that it's possible the wax might come out. You can do this repeatedly, basically. And if things are not working, then you can go to an ENT specialist. ENT specialist, basically, they also have multiple ways of taking out this wax, impacted wax. Number one is the irrigation. Irrigation with water is the one thing. Then second, they can put a small device, a curette, to actually pick it out, take it out. It's not the Q-tip. Q-tips should not be used. Clear medical recommendation is there. You should not use a Q-tip or cotton swab to put inside the ear, because impacted wax will actually be pushed inside. It will not come out, right? Only when you don't have an impacted wax on a regular basis, the Q-tips can actually take out the wax which is there lying along the walls of the ear canal. But still, that doesn't need to be taken out. It comes out by its own, right? So that's why putting a Q-tip is not needed. Thirdly, the doctor can see inside your ear with a microscope, so they can know what exactly is there and how to take it out. Sometimes we can put a jet inside. See, if there is an impaction somewhere inside, what we can do, we can actually put a jet on the upper part so that it hits the wall of the ear canal and it goes behind and pushes the earwax out. This is again syringing or irrigation which can be done. Right, so this is how doctors take out the earwax, and you can do it, right, sometimes by this. And how to clean your ear, if you don't have wax, that's a big question. You have to clean your ears while you are bathing, right, regularly. You can just clean the external ear with soap and water, and sometimes water goes inside, obviously, inside the ear canal. In that case, you can just place a wet or this thing, a paper cloth, a paper tissue, a paper cloth, or some towel in your finger, and you can just press your ear canal. And what happens? The water comes out. Water will come out, and a little bit of wax, whichever is there, will also come out. So this is how you can safely clean your ears on a daily basis without any side effect, without any injuries. Q-tips may lead to injury. It's not like you will put the Cupid and your Q-tip and you will have injuries. Multiple people actually use it and don't have injuries, but you may have injuries if there is an impacted wax. It will not completely get removed by a Q-tip. Remember that. Alright, so this is all about cleaning your ears. Remember, Q-tips and other things inserted inside the ears can lead to pierced eardrum also, right? So this is a very common problem. Make sure to share this information. Stay connected, stay healthy. I'm Dr. Paramjit. You're watching Dr. Education. Bye-bye.